clear it by Oshie. In front, back at the drive. And that was tipped off a stick wide. And then Steen is balled in the corner by Myers.
Oh, he's being held up there by Myers.
Now they're going to go. Steen and Myers, and Myers lands some rights. And the linesman jump in.
Well, the first battle in the corner, I'm sure Steen's telling the referee that he was lassoed there in the corner, and certainly Myers battling him in the long gangly arms that he has at 6'8", 220 pounds, draped all over Alexander Steen, and I'm sure Steen getting frustrated by the time he's getting released there. Good forecheck there by Oshie. Easy turnover, good shot by Backes, and here's the play in the corner here. So Myers drapes one hand around him, pushes him, he's got him held. That's a holding call in any league. And especially when you consider the first call of the game on Petteri Lindblom, and that was at full speed. This was a containment thing in the corner, and that's an easy call to make.
I don't think Steen knew he was in a fight until Myers landed a couple. And then he figured out rather quickly.
It wasn't really a fair square off there.
No, it wasn't.
General manager of the Winnipeg.
Stopped up by Michael Hutchinson. Gets it to Edstrom. He is clobbered by the captain, Landeskog. And Bufflin comes over to talk to Landeskog now. Landeskog better be careful here.
Well, Wheeler and Barry were going at it. Holden came over, and now we've got a number. Ehlers and Barry are going to go at it for sure here. This has been a raucous game right from the start. And when you look at the fact that the Jets, and guys love this stuff. These aren't two guys that do a lot of fighting. This is the intensity, the emotion of the game. And both teams appreciating these two guys going toe-to-toe. And this all stems off a hit from Landeskog on Tobias Enstrom, who's already been hurt in this game when Boschman took him down early and he landed on his shoulder in a discussion with Bufflin.
The Winnipeg Jets came in here an angry, feisty team, and they've got the Avalanche rattled right now.
Kane trying to drive it in. In for Santarelli, back for Kane. Kane and Yemelin, they've had something going this entire period, and Kane and Yemelin have the gloves off. Evander Kane and Lexi Yemelin, and Kane coming in with some rights over the top and underneath.
Wow.
Yemelin trying to hang on. And
they have been going at each other, obviously a lot of anger and frustration there on Evander Kane's part. He was throwing haymakers. When he ripped the helmet off of Yemelin, he threw it down on the ice. It almost looked like he was throwing it at Yemelin, but he threw it over top of him. And I think that Brandon Pruss had a few choice words for Kane after it was all over. Some big time haymakers on the back of the head by Evander Kane, and he is done for the night.
It starts right on the far side boards right there.
I think a little bit of a stick came up, and then an elbow came up, and then a hand came up, and then the gloves came off, and then right here, Kane is just throwing him. Yemelin's in a real susceptible position. He did the smart thing. He just literally kept his head down until he could spin around.
Winnipeg wins the draw. A shot from Trouba deflected off a body and into the corner. Peluso. Well, here's a fight behind the play. Lucas Pisa challenged again. Anthony Peluso went right after him. And he's really going after him now. This is pretty one-sided and probably should be stopped.
And this is a mismatch for sure for Pisa. He's trying to hang in there. Knew that he'd have company given that hit and nobody able to get to him last time. Thorburn tried earlier, Jim, and wasn't able to get in right after the hit. And Peluso, no hesitation at all. Perfect opportunity. The puck goes into his corner, right into your living room. And maybe that shot back by Pisa almost forced Peluso to drop the gloves. That's a mismatch in size and fights, but Pisa actually hung on and just was able to protect himself.
with one hand on the wraparound.
Runs about 240 pounds, and he's just able to shield off Jovanovski and uses the one hand. We got a fight in the middle of the ice. This time, Jack Skilly, their captain, Andrew Ladd, trying to solve the issue after that big hit. This time, Skilly's a willing dance partner against Ladd. Ladd not known for the fisticuffs.
Well, they obviously didn't like the hit by Skilly on Enstrom. And Ladd and Skilly going at it, and Skilly trying to get that hand free, did for a couple of moments. Ladd didn't take that helmet off with the shield.
Yeah, the buck shield is still in place.
And now they'll break it up, both very tired, as you can see.
Well, that's the better way, if you don't like a hit, Goldie, to solve the issue. Instead of the immediate response, wait for a different part in the game to get back after Jack Skilly. This time the captain, Andrew Ladd, takes matters into his own hands. They battle it out to the bitter end. So Skilly's been in the middle of a lot of action. The big hit in the second period.
And it's Kane with Scheifele off the bench. Comes Sill to the goal, and the Fleury takes a whack. It's Scheifele, I believe it is, right there on the doorstep.
Well, Scheifele got a piece of him after the Kane shot, hit him right under the chin, and then the stick came out. Simone Dupre's dropped the gloves again. Ooh. Kane can really fight. They're going to take off their helmets. This is extra penalties for those two. And Simone Dupre better be careful here, because Kane knocked out Matt Cook a couple years ago.
Absolutely, Bob.
Named after Evander Holyfield, Evander Kane, so look out.
He's throwing the right hands.
He's got his right hand loose.
Dupre's trying to throw rights himself.
You better not let your guard down. Oh, there it is. The right just missed, but he got him down. And that's the spirit of battle. And I give Simone Dupre high marks once again, standing up for his netminder. This game is, and listen to the crowd here now.
Well, Kane got him going. They're all standing, and he's trying to get the crowd into the game. Didn't used to be a problem for the Jets getting the crowd into the game, and now they have to be coerced into doing it as Fleury took a whack. And that's Scheifele.
Yep. Simone Dupre got right in there. And he didn't hesitate. You're not going to shy away from anything. Oof. That one there just about would have knocked many a player down, Staggy. Right on the chin. And there's that polarizing figure I spoke of. Yeah, they're talking about taking the helmets off. And if you notice the end of the fight, Simone Dupre gets taken down by Kane, Staggy, and his head is very, very close to being driven into the ice. And that's been a real problem. Take a look at the end of this fight as he gets twisted around right here. I mean, he's very close to being driven. And nope, you're in a fight there. You're in a battle. I mean, nobody cares. So, you know, they're going to try to, anything goes in a fight at that point. And he was able to keep his head up and not have it driven into the ice.
A lot of their players are sitting for, you know, 4-6 minutes watching the penalty killers out there. So it's important to get those guys out and get them back into this game.
And a goal before the end of this period for the Jets. Wouldn't that do wonders for them? Dano deep in his own zone. Puck pops up. Oh, in front of the net. That is Bennett mixing it up with Trouba. Some haymakers, and oh, Trouba coming up the worst for wear.
There has been a ton of slashing going on in this game that has not been called. Both these players are bloody. This was one heck of a bout. There was no holding back. There was just tossing and no protection. Just give and give and give. What a battle. This starts in the corner. Keep an eye on them. There's a couple of hits and then a whack, and then Bennett's going to take a slashing penalty. He's going to give Trouba a real healthy whack on the back of the legs when this turns around. And that's a two-minute penalty right there that the Calgary Flames are getting. And then they go to the front of the net, and then there's a cross-check and another cross-check. And then eventually, they just start knuckle-chucking. And I'll tell you what, there was some good bombs, and right there, Bennett came in and hit that one right through the seam, caught him right on the noggin.
Obviously, growing up a Winnipeg Jets fan, happy to see the Jets back in Winnipeg, and a little extra emotion from Calvert tonight as a result. 90 plus seconds into this hockey game. Scheifele on to Kane. Through the neutral zone. Now we've got something going. Trouba and Matt Calvert behind the play. And Trouba, who certainly has some size and reach on Calvert, but Calvert, ever the gamer, is landing some right hands here, coming on late. Matt Calvert has got Trouba tied up, and he lands those right hands before the two are separated.
Well, he tries to get something started right away. Again, one of the things tonight that the Jackets wanted to do was to get started early, and he does so. And you can see the hit. As Calvert goes in, Engstrom goes down, and then him follows is Jacob Trouba. And he gives a couple of shots to the head of Calvert. Here's an example of it right here. As he comes back off the pile, there's one shot by Trouba. And Calvert decides, hey, why not? Let's go. Trouba, he's game enough. Nice job for by Calvert. 5'10.5" against 6'2.5" Jacob Trouba.
Second fight in as many games. Do we have to call him the enforcer now?
You love the way guys play like that, and that is basically coming from the heart.
Malkin against Little. And Ryan Little wins the draw.
Here we go.
But here is Evgeny Malkin and Blake Wheeler.
Wow.
It was a hit by Malkin on Wheeler that set this up. And two guys who don't normally drop the gloves. And Wheeler exacts some revenge on Evgeny Malkin.
Boy, I'll tell you right away, they had words and you knew it was going to happen. Sestito looking down the bench as well. He's been ejected for the toughness. And Blake Wheeler was just hot after this fight. Give Evgeny Malkin a lot of credit here. He answers the bell. You like to see this. He plays with passion. He knows that he hit Wheeler high the last game, and they just square right off. This is the most honorable thing you can do off the faceoff. Drop the gloves. Let's get business out of the way. And for Blake Wheeler, obviously a little more schooled at this. Gets the better of Malkin. Nobody worse for her afterwards. Here's the hit that nobody liked. The high hit by Malkin February 16th in a really rough and tumble game. They felt Malkin got up high on Wheeler here. He didn't like the hit. It carried over into this game, the second, and it's still Johnny on the ice as this one's getting out of control.
Condra just trying to get it to a safe spot. Chips it ahead. Cassian tries to get it out as Condra is leveled in the corner. Graiba comes in after Tangredi. The mitts are off and the knuckles are flying in the corner as Condra gets back to his feet and checks his face.
There is going to be a penalty on the play. On the hit on Condra for sure. And then everyone gets involved now as Peluso and Cowan are going out of here. And Tangredi right away, Graiba jumped in.
There's a couple of big boys. Peluso 6'3", 235. Cowan 6'5", 230. Cowan takes a little knock in the chin. There's a couple of short left hands back. And
Peluso's caught him with a couple here, Dean.
Yeah, two good ones.
Yeah, yeah. He's hanging on there now.
Cowan trying to get the short left in there, but I'm not sure how much he's got left in the tank here. As Tangredi comes over the top with another right and another, and then Tangredi falls. And that'll do it. In the punch count, you'd have to give that to Tangredi, but neither one of them leaking all that much. Actually, Tangredi leaking from the nose more than anything.
I think the visor came down and caught him on the nose. A lot of punches Cowan took. Full credit to the youngster boy. He stood in there. He took him. He didn't give much space. He was not going down.